Okay, welcome back to another video and to another week of training. This evening, about to get in workout number two of the day. This morning, it was a chest and shoulders focused workout. Main exercises for the session were bench press and standing single arm shoulder press. Did 5 sets, 6 reps for both of them, and then just finished up with some accessory moves after that. It's actually coming to the final week now of the strength program I'm on. Next week will be a deload week. To be honest, I don't really feel like I need a deload week. I feel quite fresh going into all the workouts recently. I think part of that is due to the fact that my sleep has been on point. I mean, going to bed, probably just getting in bed before 10, waking up at 6, so getting about 8 hours sleep most days at the moment, for the last week or so anyway. Diet's been pretty much on point. I've been meal prepping the last week or so, and then also been taking some supplements on top of that as well. So everything's kind of keeping me fresh at the moment, I would say, on all those things together. But obviously, to keep progressing long term, it is important to take a deload week. And although I won't take it off completely, I will reduce my volume in terms of weight training. This evening's workout though is going to be a Zwift workout, so I've got it on the screen in front of me. I'll put a picture up somewhere so you can see it. Tonight is week two, I think it's session two of this FTP program I'm currently on. It is going to be a HIIT 45 second number two, so basically it says building upon your previous HIIT 45 second session that I did last week. This time it's extending the final sub threshold interval to 8 minutes. So as you can probably see, there's gonna be 6 sprints in the main part of the session, followed by a bit of a recovery, and then I'll go into that sub-threshold interval at the very end for 8 minutes. And they kind of, on Zwift, they give you an idea of how hard the workout's going to be, I guess, based on your watt output, I think anyway. And the stress point for this workout is 86, which is pretty high. So typically I do my endurance stuff in the morning, but when I saw that it was 86, I didn't really fancy doing that this morning, so I've saved it to this evening. But that's the workout for this evening. Gonna get that done now. It's gonna be an hour in total. Okay, so halfway through the main part of the session, which is 6 intervals of 45 seconds with 4 minutes recovery in between. And to be honest, I did legs on Saturday and I'm feeling it now in my quads. My quads are on fire, especially after those 45 second sprints. But the good thing is that in between those intervals with the 4 minutes recovery, my heart rate is coming down pretty quick in between. So although my legs are on fire, I'm recovering pretty quick in between each interval, which is a good sign. And now we've got 3 more of these, and then it's a 3 minute recovery after, followed by the 8 minute sub-threshold part of the session. Okay, that is this evening's workout complete. Just cooling down now, I've got 5 minutes to cool down, which by the end of it, probably distance will be 21 kilometers or just over for the session, which isn't too bad. Overall, I think the hardest part were the 45 second intervals. My quads were just blowing up, they're on fire, but the actual 8 minute sub-threshold interval after them wasn't too bad, which is a good sign. 2 weeks in now, starting to get a nice rhythm on the bike, which is really good, and hopefully in 2 weeks' time, well, technically, just under 3 weeks' time, when I do the FTP test again, hopefully we can get a better score, so. Okay, that is this morning's Zwift session complete, 1 hour in total, and the main part of the session was a 15 minute tempo followed by 4 sprints for 2 minutes each, and then followed by a 3 minute recovery. It was quite an intense session, to be honest, especially after yesterday's Zwift workout in the evening, but it's done for the day now, so we'll crack on with breakfast. Then we've got work, and then a leg workout this evening. Leg and backs workout this evening. Backs, back. Okay, this is what we're working with supplements-wise. Tropica Superfood Greens, probably the best tasting greens I've found so far. Only problem is they're based in Australia, so shipping wise it can take a while to arrive. Again from Tropica, Camu Camu. This is a little something I'm working on myself, a little kind of side project. And then we've got some BPN In Focus, so this is kind of to replace having an energy drink or coffee in the morning basically, and does the job. It's going to be front squats to start with, 5 sets, 6 reps, and then I'm going to move on to deficit deadlifts. Again, that's also going to be 5 sets, 6 reps, and then going to do a little bit of accessory work. So I'll probably do some bent over rows and like Bulgarian split squats. Nothing too intense, not too much volume, because my legs are pretty fried, to be honest, from the last 2 Zwift sessions, and I've got a run tomorrow. So I want to keep some sort of freshness in the legs for the run. But at the same time, I do want to get a bit of strength work in. So we're going to stick with the compound moves this evening, a little bit of accessory work, and then we'll call it a night there. So let's get into it. Well, I'm the first one to say ladies first, last one at the bar with the thirst, yeah. Hard to hit and hard to look, that's right. Open up a can of ale and a fight. Yeah, that's whiskey and cigarettes on my bread. Bumping an old top Benny cassette. Hope said he smiles when I meet him, cause I'm Southern and it ain't my fault. My daddy came from Louisiana like the hot sauce. Southern and it ain't my fault. Yeah, this is how it roll, baby, this is how it roll. Well, my family's full of crazy kids. From the looks of me and say, well, it's contagious, cause I can feel it running down through my blood, yeah. And it fits like a boom, big tires to mud. If you don't like me, that's alright. You can kiss my ass and honey, I'll get by now, cause where I'm from, that's what we do, yeah. If you was born down here, you probably do it too.